All right, I'm gonna get a little governmental. It appears we have all these fires raging in California, and it kind of is bringing in, you know, as you know, throughout our lives, you know, there's another thing, the catastrophic event happens, and another one, and you see all these people in these terrible situations, and I'm like, well, how can we stop this? You know, that pandemonium zone when the people have just lost their house, especially for the elderly, and they are like completely homeless, and they push them into like these community centers, and they live little tiny place next to each other, and then they have to live in hotels, and I mean, it just, I don't see an answer. In the old days, maybe churches took them, but I don't think they can handle this amount or that quantity of human beings. So anyway, this is just like, what was it, the FEMA, instead of FEMA, because I don't think they are helping human beings in that particular way. This would be more like a volunteer program that is in every city, every town, where you run yourself, you write yourself down as the volunteer, that you would donate a room of your house, and you would give them room and board for one or two people during such a catastrophic event for at least 3 months, okay? Now, that type of thing would just be a list that's kept with the local city, and so it would be a matching list, and it could just be only the people, if you want to be weirdo and say only people within my 5 perimeter block, I will accept. You know, some people are like that, you know, they only want people from certain wage classes, etc. So that will go on, but I would rather have them housed than living in terrible situations. Because many people will volunteer, but they need to know what the terms and conditions are. And as long as they're compensated, you know, so the seniors also, so the people who sign up for the list would be knowing full well that they could be also needing these charitable donation moments, you know, of housing. So they would say, well, what is the deal? You know, I can pay, you know, so you would have to have that written, like what you could give out to pay during a catastrophic event to a volunteer house. Because the volunteer house, you know, they're still going to have to feed you, you know, and pay their bills because you're there. And they may even need to have home health care, you know, coming into the house, you know, a nurse or something. So I don't know. It's just something that seems to be missing with all of this catastrophic evacuation procedure. There doesn't seem to be like a simple house matching service. So you as a volunteer would go and you'd sign on the list and say, yeah, I volunteer my house in the event of. Under the same terms and conditions that I'm also, you know, on the list in the event it happens to me. So if my house burned down, somebody else would take me in, etc., to their house. So it goes both ways. So the volunteer or the evacuee, they both could be. That list can be used synonymously as this at the same. So, and that could be something set up pretty easy through databases. It would just have a list of those people and their ages and if they have pets, and then these people in your neighborhood or near your neighborhood who have decided to volunteer, and they say you can bring your pet, and so there you go. You have a match, and she said, well, there's Mrs. Williams or I don't know, Frank, whatever, Walker, and Myla Jane, Wonig. So there they are on the list, and say, oh, I already know Myla, and we get along. I've seen her at the store, so that would be like, hey, great. So. So Myla's on the list, and she'll take you in to, she has an extra room under these circumstances. So that's the type of thing that I'm really thinking that's gone amiss, obviously, because we don't have like this great religious network any longer. We have more and more people, most people, just especially, well, I'll say the coast specifically, but when you get in like into to the deep heart of the United States, I don't know, it gets religious clustery, but speaking of smothering, but this is an answer. I'm just saying this is an answer to because I don't want to see a 95-year-old woman out there, and she doesn't have a house anymore. I mean, it's just absurd. I don't want to see her walking around with her teddy bear on TV. She needs to be put in the house, like right away. I mean, that's just stupid. That is the stupidest thing I've ever seen. And that's just bad planning, it's bad management. So something can be amended, so it's just simple lists. People donate their charitable selves for a minimum of time. And then, you know what? That person doesn't have to live with you forever. And if you don't get along, you can always say, help, go back to the list. We need to swap. This woman and us, we just don't jive. But it's the point that you're available, and you give that safety. That's all. Anyway, so that's enough of my government FEMA. My government FEMA fix. Yeah, let's fix FEMA. Well, no, it's just a list, and at this point, as volunteers of these citizens of the U.S., it has nothing to do with the government, it seems, isn't it? It just seems to be nothing to do with the government anymore. They're just, I don't know. They're there with the helicopters and water. Thank you for that. But that's really all I think the government is good for. I've seen them pick the water up out of those lakes and dump it on the surrounds. You know, they're good for that. But they're not really good for the people. So when it comes to being good for the people, it's really going to be the people, you know. And so this is it, you know, charitable list. And I guess we'll have to call it evacuation list. I would like to join the evacuation list in my city, you understand? So I would be listed there, and then it would just have my name, it would have the address, it would have the dogs yes, cats no, or cats yes, dogs no. It would have that type of information, and that's fine. That's fine. One person only, or three people, you know, it could be that. Elders only, seniors only. And so those types, and then that's it. And then there's the matches. And that is wonderful. And that's like a relief. A relief. Because it's not, you know, just because these catastrophic events happen, it's not supposed to kill you through stress and anxiety and... No, I mean, it's not your fault. Some stupid idiot made a campfire. It's not your fault, you know. So we're not supposed to be killing human beings, you know, causing them shorter lifespans over one idiot, okay? I don't know the sequence. I don't really know who. I just know that that's what they're saying it was. And I know I said dogs and cats, but then, of course, people have horses. And those facilities, you know, those people will be on the list, you know, great, you know, there's 50 people right away that have horse stables ready. And so that type of hello, you know, that could happen, you know. So those guys with horses and these ones with horses, they, in the event of fire on either, their horses are saved. So those types of things. That's all it is, you know, and I don't know why. It seems like the government has dropped the ball, dropped the ball big time. And I'm like, and there's first ladies, and there's first ladies, and there's first ladies, and there's first ladies. And I'm not really sure what they're doing when it comes to these events. I didn't see anything big happen. So, anyway, this is my input. And anyway, yeah, I guess Michelle Obama was good. She made the garden there. That was helpful. That was helpful. Yeah, yeah, I think so. So I guess they help in strange, odd ways. Yeah. I still don't see all the flowers, though, from Lyndon B. Johnson's wife. She started the flowers along the freeways, and I don't see them anymore. So it's like they had the first lady and then dropped the ball. You know what I mean? You have to keep the continuum. First ladies are like gems. They're little gems, and they have their little input moment. And you just have to take, that one did this, and then this one did the other, and this one did the other, okay? And, you know, I remember even, what's his name? Bush, his wife, George Bush's wife. She was just so good with the education, with the kids, the young kids, getting them to read. You know, so you have these little smattering moments. This is the woman that did this, and the woman did that, and then it's just like, I know, I can't get actually mad at them because that you can't get them to do everything, you know, just because the president doesn't and their vice president doesn't or their council don't, you know, I can't get mad at them, you know. I can't help but know this stuff. I just can't help but know this stuff, sorry. But yeah, the lists. We make the evacuation lists. And then, well, Mrs. Queen of France here, you know, with my big ego. My big ego, yeah. Anyway, yeah, so paradise is gone. The town of paradise. Interesting image is if you go to Wikipedia and you look at paradise, you'll see the John Brueger with the parrots, and it's very much like a warm River Thames. It's very beautiful and has the idyllic. Oh, it's not an Eden necessarily, but paradise is often called as a heaven, isn't it? It's often referred to as a heaven. Or if you go with the cosmologicals, those ones, they say that the planet Earth was heaven. The planet Earth was heaven until it was paradise, until evil was created. So anyway, it's how you look at it. But anyway, very, 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 in an odd way, it's a decisive moment for a lot of people when the town of paradise burns. Even if you haven't been there, I think it is very, very momentous. It's a big being factor, isn't it? Like, what does paradise mean to you, you know? What does it mean to you? Sometimes paradise is just being saved at that moment and just, oh my God, somebody's going to take me into their house and I'm going to get a meal tonight. And I'm not going to have anxiety attack and panic. Oh my God, and I have a place for my cats. Sometimes that is paradise, you know, right here on this earth. So anyway, so we're looking out at these lists. So I had such a cruddy name, evacuation list, but it has to be a volunteer evacuation list, just like a voter list. And it should be there, you know, when you sign up to vote, it should be right there. Are you going to be an evacuation volunteer, a housing? And then you could check that box and say, yes, I am. And then it says, okay, well, then go ahead and fill out this form and then tell us what you have as far as how many rooms and how many people, dogs or cats or you know, goats, whatever. But yeah, that type of thing, you know, that's how the government can help. You just add that extra little checkbox and then extra little form, and then we start making these lists, and these lists save people, you know, they become a salvation. And yeah, a lot less, you know, less crime, because you're going to have people now that are just like, I have no house, I have no house. I have like no insurance, because there's a lot of people out there, they have no insurance either. So now they have no house, they have no insurance. Damn sure they have no job anymore, because maybe even that's been burned down in a lot of these towns. So you're gonna have real problems starting to occur. You know, petty theft and petty crime were from people who didn't even plan on it ever in their lives. Okay, so rawr, guys. Gosh dang it, government. Stop dropping the ball.